स्टूडेंट्स अगेन वेलकम टू अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन दैट इज नंबर 5 इंट्रोडक्शन टू मैन्युफैक्चरिंग दैट इज मशीनिंग ऑपरेशंस ऑन मिलिंग मशीन एंड डायरेक्टली गोइंग टू दी पर्टिकुलर स्लाइड व्हिच विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द ऑपरेशंस ऑन मिलिंग मशीन. दीज आर द ऑपरेशंस व्हिच आर इंक्लूडेड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर स्लाइड्स एज फार एज मिलिंग मशीन इज कंसीडर्ड वन. द फर्स्ट ऑपरेशन इज द प्लेन मिलिंग. What do you mean by plain milling? It is nothing but the up milling and down milling process. A machining is done in this case of up milling and down milling process by the teeth on the cylindrical surface of the cutter. Already we have discussed what do you mean by milling cutter. It is nothing but a multi-point, you can say, circular disc which is having the multi-point points, cutting points on it, which will be responsible for removal of the material from the workpiece. Finished surface is parallel to the axis of the cutter here in this case. Now here this figure is explaining you that this is the cutter, which is no doubt the rotation, how it can get that already I have explained you, and this is the feed as far as the workpiece is considered one. Now in this case the rotation of this particular milling cutter is in a clockwise direction, and in the similar manner the feed will be given opposite to it. In which manner the rotation of this particular cutter will be there, the feed will be given, it is in clockwise direction, that is the cutter is moving in clockwise direction, and the feed which is available one as far as the workpiece is considered one, which will be, you can say, to the right hand side as far as whenever it is moving in clockwise direction. So we cannot say that it is just opposite to it actually, because it is just moving into the right hand side. But while in case of down milling process, actually the milling cutter will be moving in counterclockwise direction, that is anti-clockwise direction, that is moving in such a manner. But at the same time, the feed of that particular workpiece will be the same, that is right hand side. So in this case, such a kind of operation or the removal of the material will take place, and which is nothing but the down milling. So that is the thing. Up milling means you can say the cutter will be moving in clockwise direction and the feed will be the right hand side. It may be vice versa also. Try to remember this one. It depends upon the position of the workpiece and as well as the movement of the milling cutter. So try to remember this. Operations performed on another, that is the milling machines, which are different from this plane, that is down milling and up milling, that is the face milling. Now in this case, here whatever the top portion of any kind of component, that will be just given a proper shape and size. Now this machining is done by the teeth on the flat surface of the cutter. This finished surface is perpendicular to the axis of the cutter. Finished surface is perpendicular to the axis of the cutter, and here finished surface is parallel to the axis of the cutter. That is very well. So this is the axis of the cutter, and this surface is parallel to the axis of the cutter. But in this case, axis of the cutter is like this one, and the finished surface is like this one. So finished surface is perpendicular to the axis of the cutter, and the material from this top surface will be removed whenever the rotation of this one is take place either in clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. But the feed, you need to give certain kind of motion to this workpiece so that the upper part of this particular surface will be machined in proper manner. Side milling, whenever the component which is to be machined or from which the material can be removed, that can be placed, and if we wanted to remove the material either from this side or from this side apart from top and bottom, then the cutter will be mounted on the arbor assembly in this manner, and it is having to its side, instead of having, you can say here, the cutting, you can say, point like this one, it is having the cutting points along its side, so that the removal of the material from the side of any kind of workpiece can be possible one. This machining is done by the teeth on the cylindrical surface of the cutter, and finished surface, here finished surface is what? It is parallel to the axis of the this particular cutter. That is the, you can say, location of the workpiece and the cutter. In case of side and face milling, both are simultaneously, we can have this kind of structure which is available one, in which machining is done by the this particular teeth which are available on flat as well as on cylindrical surface. So the machining is available on this multi point cuttings are available on flat as well as on this cylindrical surface also. Try to remember this. And in this case, the finished surfaces are perpendicular to axis as well as parallel. Now this particular surface, side one, is parallel, and this one is parallel actually, and this one will be perpendicular. Try to remember this one. It depends upon that which kind of operations, either side or either face milling is going on. Now here in this case actually, if at all it will be there here, this will be, this surface will be perpendicular to this, not to the axis of this particular cutter, but to this particular face it will be perpendicular to that one. Try to remember this one. So therefore, finished surfaces are perpendicular as well as parallel to the axis of the cutter. Now here in this case, another operations which can be carried out are end milling operation, profile milling operation, and gang milling operation. Now in case of end milling operations, the machining is done by the cutter points or teeth which are available on the end as well as periphery of the cutter. So that means here in this case, the cutter is having along its you can say surface, the cutting teeth are available and it can have a certain kind of contour like structure which will remove the material from the workpiece like this one. So that is the end milling operation. It is used for machining of complicated profiles. Therefore, I have used the word here that is nothing but the contouring. Or the contour, whatever the shape of that contour is available one, the shape is available one along that one, that particular milling cutter can be moved in proper manner. So that is the end milling operation. Here also another thing, that is profile milling. Now here it will be on a plane surface which is having a polygonal shape like square, hexagonal, or maybe rectangular, triangular. But if a surface is of cylindrical kind and if you wanted to remove the material in certain kind of profile, that may be having a gear like structure like this one. Okay, so in that case the cutter has an outline same as that of the shape of the profile here. So this milling cutter is having such a kind of profile which will remove the material from this circular disc like this way. This disc is such a kind of structure which is known as gear blank actually, and along this gear blank, if you wanted to remove the material, it will be converted in such a kind of structure that is having the gear. Okay, if you wanted to remove that one, so such a kind of gear can be, you can say, manufactured on this particular circular disc that is nothing but the gear blank. So for that one, such a special cutters are used which are nothing but having the outline of the same kind of profile which we wanted to generate on the periphery of that circular part. So it is used for gear teeth manufacturing. Gang milling is what, two or more milling cutters are mounted on the arbor assembly. That is the only thing. Is instead of only one milling cutter, if two or more milling cutters are available one, then that kind of machine is known as gang milling machine. So simultaneously the two kinds of profiles or two kinds of at two locations the materials can be removed from the workpiece. Here you can observe that it is available one, the material is this one workpiece, and the material will be removed at this location and at this location with the help of this milling cutter. Okay, this will be also you just see here, this is the arbor assembly on which this milling cutter is mounted. This is the plain milling cutter which is available one here. Okay, this is for side and face milling cutter as well as this is for side and face milling cutter. So different kinds of milling, that is side milling, face milling, or the plane milling, all these things can be possible with the help of this gang milling operation or gang milling cutter. Another operation which will be the saw milling, that is a slitting operation which can be converting the parts into two halves, not completely in two halves we can say, but having certain separation. So that is the thing as far as the saw milling. The thickness of the saw milling is from 0.75 to 5 millimeter thick. It is used for cutting deep slots or for cutting off operations. It can be used for cutting off also, but generally it is used for cutting deep slots having certain kind of depth in it. Keyway milling. Keyway is nothing but what, this is a slot which is available one for the location or for the entry of a key, which is used one for avoiding the relative motion between the two parts, that is a shaft and the bearing, or shaft and the pulley, or maybe the coupling, you can say flanges which are mounted on it to avoid the relative motion. So that keyways can be generated, can be, you can see, manufactured using the side and face milling cutters on the horizontal milling machine, or end milling cutters on vertical milling machine operations. Okay, like this one. Actually, if we see such a kind of shaft is generally available one. I'm just drawing. This was the. This is actually the part of design. So this is the shaft. But up to some depth, the shaft is having such a kind of slot like this one. Okay. So this is the key ways which is and this shaft is going on like it right now, means at the end part of this one like this. So this key way can be manufactured with the help of this key way milling operation as far as the shaft is concerned. Now here the key way is starting from this particular edge of that particular shaft itself, but here in this case the key way is having at the certain location from this end or from this end. Okay. I think yes, 1 minute. Okay, I'm just removing that one right now. So I think this is okay, that how this keyway can be manufactured with the help of this particular keyway milling machine. So we will just stop right now here. I think this all the operations has been completed as far as this particular operations on milling machine part is considered. These are the references which I have used one from SlideShare for making this particular presentation for whole, that is what you mean by lathe machine operation, lathe machine components, lathe machine operations, milling machine components and milling machine operations. So we'll stop here. I hope you will be try to just observe this particular videos in proper manner, watch this video so that some basic points related to this particular topic will be cleared in very proper manner. So thank you very much. We will stop here.